Hello, my name is Mohammad Asif and I will connect Java NetBeans 11.1 Mavic project with Microsoft SQL Server Management Studio database. I have divided this video into three simple steps that we will execute one by one. First of all, open Microsoft SQL Server, any version, the steps are the same. By the way, you can download these instructions from the link given. I will provide it in the description of this video. After opening my SQL Server Management Studio, just click on Connect. It will connect you to your default server that is your system. After connecting to your server, you need to right click on your server and then click on properties. Here in properties, you will see securities. Click on security and then hover to server authentication. Check this option, SQL Server and Windows authentication mode, and click OK. It says that these actions will take effect after the SQL Server is restarted. So you need to restart SQL Server. To restart, right click on the server and click on restart. Click on yes. So our server is restarted successfully. After restarting your server, click on securities, logins, right click on logins and create on and click on new login. Here in new login window, choose a login name. I am selecting root and change this to SQL Server authentication. Choose a password. In my case, it is also root, and confirm the password. Here in server roles, select these roles: database creator, security admin, server admin, system admin. That's all. In the user mapping, select your database which you want to give control to the root user that you are creating now. I am selecting HR system, that is my created database, master model and this database. That's all. Check status that it is permission is granted and login is enabled. Select OK. So I have already created the root, that's why it gives me the error message. So I will create a new username that is admin. Password is admin. Confirm password admin. Okay. Admin is also created. Sorry, but I have created root and admin. So my user login user is Asif. Password is also Asif. Confirm password is Asif. Select OK. Extend the logins folder, you will see your new user. Disconnect the database and try to reconnect the database server. Here in authentication, click on SQL Server Authentication. Write the login that you have created, just created. My login is Asif and password is also Asif. Click on connect. Here it prompted to enter new password. It really happens when you have newly created all. So my new password is the same as the previous one. Okay, it is connected, that's all. Now the next step you will require is to enable TCP IP using SQL Server Manager. To do so, here is its location: C Windows System, SysWoo 64, SQL Server Manager 10. Now this 10 can be changed in your case. It depends on the version of your SQL Manager. It can be 10, 11, 12, up to 15. So click open this PC, C drive, Windows, SysWoo 64. Here is my folder. Then open SQL Server Manager 10.msc. SQL Server. Here is SQL Server Manager 10.msc. Just open it. After opening SQL Server Configuration Manager, click on SQL Server Network Configuration 32. Double click on Protocols, and here is TCP IP protocol, which is by default disabled. Right click on it and enable it. Click OK. Right click and click on Properties. Click on IP addresses. Scroll down the window. IPA 11. Check the TCP port. In my case, it is 1433. It is default port for TCP IP of SQL Server Configuration Manager. So OK. Note down this TCP port. After enabling TCP IP, you need to restart your SQL Server Management Studio. So restart, click yes. It is successfully restarted. Now minimize this window. We have successfully completed our first step. Now unzip. You will require SQL drivers to connect Java program to your SQL Server Management Studio. I have provided a link to download the drivers in the description of this video. You can go and download these drivers. After downloading these drivers, you will require to unzip these drivers anywhere on your PC. This is the folder. Double click on this SQL Java Database Connectivity 4.0.22.06. Select your folder or location to unzip this folder. I am unzipping this in C drive. OK. Click on unzip. 1288 files unzipped successfully. Click OK and close this window. Now come to C drive. SQL Java Database Connectivity 4.0. This is the jar file that we will require to connect our Java program with SQL Server Management Studio. Open Apache NetBeans 11.1. So we have to create new, click on File, New Project. Java with Maven, select Java application, next, project name, my project name is connection with SQL. So this is my new project, click on source package. Your default package and new Java class. My class name is connection SQL. Click on finish. Let's delete the comments. Okay, we have created this class. After creating the class, click on dependencies. By default there is no dependencies, so click on project file, pom.xml file, double click on it. So in the dependencies you are required to add the following code lines. These are the code lines that you will require to add in your folder. Few lines are missing there, so first I will add them here so that to make it easy for you. Dependencies, and here copy this code and paste it here. Save it by pressing Ctrl plus S. Now cross it and click on your project. Right click on your project and click on clean and build. So it has successfully rebuilt our project. After that, click on dependencies. Here you will see this new jar file. Right click on it, click on manually install artifact, click on browse and select the jar file that you have just installed. In my case, I have installed it on C drive. SQL Java Database Connectivity 4.0 ENU and SQL Java Database Connectivity 4.jar. Double click on it and click on install locally. Here you will see the progress of installing the artifact. It have installed the new artifacts for us. So this is the package that we will require to connect the Java program with SQL Server Management Studio. Come back to the Java class and write code with me. I will also provide the code to you in the link that I have shared in the description of this video. Public static void main string ARGS arguments. The first thing you will need is the try and catch blocks. Try and catch. Exception E. system.out.println e. It will print any exception that will occur in our try block. In our try block, we will first of all required to register our drivers. For registering our driver, we need the one line code that is class dot So here we have to write JDBC, Java Database Connect it. Compile it again. So here is our result. Our ID, name Asif Khan, salary, our department, here is our database, department, employee position and CNIC, employee position and CNIC, which is 1101 dummy variable. That's all. Thank you for watching this video, and if you have any queries, please comment your queries. I will try my best to respond your all questions. Thank you for watching.